For EMBB, our target was 20 gigabits per second peak data rate and about 100 megabits per second at the cell edge. How is having this new frequency range going to help us accomplish this?
In 4G, the channels are like pipes. The pipe can range from a 1.4 megahertz wide bandwidth channel up to a 20 megahertz channel. The size of the pipe determines how much data can flow through. In Release 10 of LTE Advanced, we're able to put 5 of those pipes together to provide more throughput to the user. This is called carrier aggregation. Because 5G can use the 28 and 39 gigahertz ranges, or the millimeter wave spectrum, we can allocate a larger pipe. In initial 5G deployments, the pipe can be as large as 400 megahertz. This, coupled with technologies like MIMO, gives us the ability to provide more bandwidth to the user so Kit can broadcast her daily lip treatment routine in high-definition virtual reality.
Thanks for the briefing on lip treatment, Jen. Maybe you can tell us how using the new frequency ranges affects our URLLC use case.
The URLLC use case requires very low delay of information transmitted over the air. At higher frequencies, we can transmit the same amount of data in a shorter amount of time compared to lower frequencies. In 4G, the minimum transmission time is 1 millisecond for a specific amount of data. In 4G and 5G, that 1 millisecond duration is known as the subframe time. In 4G, that subframe is divided into 2 slots, so the slot time is 0.5 milliseconds. The slot is the smallest granularity at which data can be scheduled for transmission. In addition, the pipe is larger in 5G, up to 400 megahertz. The pipe is subdivided into individual data streams, or subcarriers. An important characteristic of the transmission is that the larger the separation between the subcarriers, the less time it takes to transmit the same amount of data. Which means that if the subcarrier spacing is larger, the slot time is smaller. In other words, we can transmit more slots in the same amount of time compared to 4G. The larger pipe in 5G provides greater flexibility for the spacing between the subcarriers.
So, you're saying that we can transmit more slots in the same amount of time? How does this help us achieve lower latency?
Good question, Micah. It's all about how rapidly the device and the G-Node B can schedule and send information. Remember, the slot is the smallest granularity at which data can be scheduled for transmission. If the slot time is shorter, then data can be transmitted in shorter intervals. Over-the-air latency is reduced to less than a millisecond compared to 4G. The result is quicker delivery of information. With 5G, Zombie Crusher will have faster response times. With sub-millisecond transactions, the zombies won't stand a chance.
Thanks, Jen. Using the millimeter wave spectrum, we allocate a larger pipe to help Kit Karfashian get the bandwidth she needs for live streaming. Higher frequencies transmit the same amount of data in a shorter amount of time compared to lower frequencies, giving Zombie Crusher the fast response time he needs for mobile gaming. But how are changes in the air interface for 5G going to get Frank to work on time?
In the massive machine-type communications use case, MMTC, we have massive amounts of devices running on low power and typically using smaller amounts of data and short transmission times. Carrier separation will allow us to better share the information and provide for all the different types of devices, enabling lots of devices to transmit in short bursts with a larger carrier separation. Using MIMO beamforming technology, we can aim spotlights to multiple places. That means we can more efficiently allot radio resources. MIMO technology can focus on a specific device at a distinct location to deliver the data as needed. By allotting only the resources needed for specific devices, And by being able to have this focused MIMO beamforming technology means that they use less power. The G-Node B can listen and transmit better by aiming antennas to a specific device. Depending on the scenario, we may use sub-6 GHz spectrum for enhanced coverage reliability. As Frank drives to work, the 5G air interface enables multiple devices to communicate between themselves and the city infrastructure. Using radio resources more efficiently through carrier separation allows them to communicate in short bursts. MIMO beamforming technology can listen and transmit to specific devices so the devices save power. The devices communicate seamlessly, timing traffic to avoid congestion so that Frank's commute flows smoothly.